Today, I'm unpacking this box of Pinocchio collectibles. And after I unpack the box, I'll be cleaning the items and examining them and taking an inventory and arranging them on the shelves. So there'll be some sounds associated with books and pages. And some box sounds, and quiet talking, soft speaking, and whispers while I look at the contents of the collection. Pinocchio. And I have a couple of pencils in here that are topped with these, like vinyl pencil toppers. They're stuck on there permanently, they're not coming off. So I have Jiminy Cricket. And Pinocchio and the Sorcerer's Apprentice. He's out of place. He does not belong in there. This one is Jiminy Cricket. I don't know who made these. It's in a bunch of different languages. Five different languages. Pinocchio card game. It hasn't been opened before. It's still in the shrink wrap. It's kind of damaged, though. It's got cute illustrations. They're just tiny cards. They have a Pinocchio right there. Instructions, lamp wick, monstro, coachman, fox and cat, Figaro, Cleo. This is a little teacup. Matching plate, and this little red thing is a little plate holder to prop up the plate. What is this? This is from the days of Beta. That was when VHS and Beta were competing. It's puffy. I don't know what makes it puffy, but it's kind of squishy. What happens? Pop it open. It goes to a Linux spice rack. I remember this Linux spice rack had different movies for each different spice. The Pinocchio one. Spice jar collection from Linux. It's a nice topper. PVC. He can stand up. Sit down. I remember some of these ones. They're lenticular. The picture changes when you move it. There's a couple different ones. Pinocchio. Pinocchio was a real boy at last. The Golden Book, 1992. Here is Walt Disney Pinocchio cockamamies. They're like temporary tattoos This one comes with a record. It's got a picture of Pinocchio right there. Story and Songs, 1977. Newsprint. The Blue Fairy does not look friendly right there. This is my favorite hardback book of Pinocchio. I like how it's just very pretty. The font is big, and every page has this pretty frame. The illustrations are really crisp. It's definitely a chapter book for kids. I like it. Here we have some little figurines. There's Pinocchio and the Blue Fairy. Something called Tiny Kingdom. The figurines are sitting inside their box on what looks like a stage with a bunch of characters in the background as an audience. This cup is from Burger King. It's Pinocchio. And I have a couple of pencils in here that are topped with these, like, vinyl pencil toppers. They're stuck on there permanently. They're not coming off, I think. Yeah, they're stuck on. Jiminy Cricket and Pinocchio and the Sorcerer's Apprentice. He's out of place. He does not belong in there. In the back of the cup, it's like a little Coca-Cola symbol and Burger King. Here's another Tiny Kingdom. This one is Jiminy Cricket. I don't know who made these. It's in a bunch of different languages. Like, 5 different languages. There's a little ornament. This is from Disneyland. It's ceramic. Pinocchio card game. It hasn't been opened before, it's still in the shrink wrap. It's kind of damaged though. It's got cute illustrations. Look at that. He's really cute. This is another card game. Like a matchbox, how like Jiminy Cricket slept in a wee little matchbox. They're just tiny cards. They have Pinocchio right there. instructions, lamp wick, monstro, coachman, fox and cat, Figaro, Cleo. Actually in pretty good shape. I wonder how old it is. This isn't gonna say how old it is. Cards in a case of some kind. Cases taped shut. It'd be interesting to look through those. This is a little teacup and matching plate. And this little red thing is a little plate holder to prop up the plate. More Burger King cups. Nosy facts for the 1940 release of Disney's second animated feature film. Animators used actual puppets and took puppetry classes to capture Pinocchio's movements realistically. The days of beta. That was when VHS and beta were competing. It's puffy. I don't know what makes it puffy. But it's kind of squishy. It's popped up. Somebody rewound the movie. That was considered. The copyright is in Roman numerals. And it's embossed right there. The classic. Kind of hear that. The equipment to watch that. Got a little plushie, and Geppetto plushie, and Jiminy Cricket plushie. He's got a little price tag. That's from Big Lots. But when I don't know what I'm gonna find, what is it gonna be? It goes to a Linux spice rack. I remember this Linux spice rack hat different movies for each different spice. That's the Pinocchio one. Spice jar collection from Lennox. It's a nice topper. Interesting. Now it doesn't want to go on there very well. Maybe if I line up the Pinocchio with the description. Nope. It's just Buffy now. There's another Jiminy Cricket. What is he holding? His umbrella. Oh, there's another. Tiny Kingdom figurine. That's Figaro. I think I already had Figaro. There's a Pinocchio doll. He's made of like PVC. He can stand up. These are rubber stamps. They haven't come out of their packaging. They're made by this company, All Night Media. I used to buy so many of their stamps. This bag has some postcards. It doesn't have a date on it. Printed in England, though. I remember some of these ones. They're lenticular. The picture changes when you move it. There's a couple different ones. Dancing. Workshop. Dancing the workshop. Dancing. This one there in the battle with Monstro, and Geppetto goes to rescue him. This one. That one's just kind of a weird 3D thing. It's another a little tiny snow globe. Jiminy Cricket has a little hat on here. Pinocchio hat. It's really small. Called Jiminy. Watch this. Really ugly. Yeah, I don't know where this came from, but it's terrible. I think his hand's about to fall off entirely. cassette of Pinocchio. It's red. This tape cassette. That whole Disneyland font. I love it when Disneyland had that font. Here's our board book. Pinocchio. Pinocchio was a real boy at last. It's a golden book. 1992. Here is Walt Disney Pinocchio cockamamies. They're like temporary tattoos. Like you moisturize your hand and stick the picture on there. Gosh, this is original $1. There's no date on it. Probably have to open it to get a date. It's a Pinocchio acrylic paint by number. Has these two pictures to be painted. One's by Hasbro. It's kind of crushed. I don't see a date on it. Those would have been really fun to have all those. Paint by number. Most of what's left are books. This is from that book club, Wonderful World of Reading. Gosh, it's dirty. I think that's the only version that I have, though. A little golden book of Pinocchio. They're like the exact same thing. This is the read along. I think this might go with this because it's supposed to have a tape with it. They might go together. This one comes with a record. It's got a picture of Pinocchio right there. Story and Songs, 1977. Page book. This is a Super 8 film for Pinocchio. I've never watched it in this format. Another little golden book, Pinocchio. And a puzzle. It's only 63 pieces. Whitman comic book, 60 cents. Newsprint. The Blue Fairy does not look friendly right there. You have to wait until the very back cover to get the happy ending. Another puzzle. That's a 200 piece puzzle. Golden. And this book. A big golden book. Another golden book. This one's paperback. Copyright 1984. Originally 1953, that's why these illustrations look so vintage. That's definitely 1950s. Book from Toys R Us. Another coloring book. This is my favorite hardback book of Pinocchio. I like how it's just very pretty. The font is big. And every page has this pretty frame. The illustrations are really crisp. It's definitely a chapter book for kids. I like it a lot. Version. I don't know how many versions of Pinocchio you can have. This isn't the story of Pinocchio, this is something else. Something else to the collection. 1986. I don't know what's going on in that book. Choose Your Own Adventure. There were Choose Your Own Adventure books when I was growing up, but they were paperback. I don't remember this one. There's another hardback book with original illustrations for the motion picture. This is a fun. I have no idea what that is. this is a fun inside cover with all these illustrations. I think that's stuff that's from Geppetto's workshop. Little pipe. Little clocks in Geppetto's woodshop. And other toys. Each of these pages has pretty little like drawings. I haven't seen those in other pages or other books. One big letter that's decorative. Yeah, I like this one a lot with all the extra drawings. Golden book. Copyright 1953. There's those very vintage illustrations. It's bound with little strings. That's the binding as the strings. I loved sticker fun books when I was little. You punch out the little stickers, and each page tells you. Like, see, it says, place these stickers on the finger puppet shapes on page 15. So you punch them out, and then you lengthen them. This is kind of got a glue on the back, and then you find the places where they go. They put little dotted lines. The little dotted lines are where the stickers go, and I guess these are making finger puppets. I've seen this sticker fun book in a long time. These are postage stamps from Granada. Another big golden book. Thirty-third printing, 1980. That's amazing. Making of a masterpiece. It's got very vibrant, glossy artwork in there. It talks about making the movie. There's Walt Disney playing with his puppet. a fun book to look at. The complete story and all the songs and the music, plus a 24-page colored illustrated book especially prepared for children by the Walt Disney Studio. Narrated by Jiminy Cricket. Copyright 1971. Another record. That one still has the record on it. That one's old.